for the St. John High School, Ben Campbell, number one, Mike Daly, Liam Darling, Devin Jacob, Josh Hebert, Chesley, John Gillen, Sam Dumuchel, Gerald Price, Matt White, Jason Gillen, Riley Levitt, Patty Curry, Keegan Hartley, Dominic Gray, and Tristan DeRosier. On the Harrison Trimble side, starting at number one, Justin Shannon, Ryan Sampson, Ikab Saleh, Vincent McAllister, Tyler Isles, Mark Emo, Matt Oxner, Brody Fall, Kyle Furs, Damon Hamer, Brendan Oblinas, Maku Atu, Justin Wojcik, Keegan McIntyre, and Hazer Hazgul. Now we'll direct your attention back to the field for O Canada. Please stand and remove your hats. As the teams get ready.
Here, I'll take Eric. Thank you. Good job. Oh, you guys can come around if you want to.
Do you want to tell me who won the coin toss? St. John High School will be kicking to Harrison Trimble. Start.
Can you pass me that gray bin, the whole thing? Could you just kind of slide whatever's on top underneath there on the...
First penalty of the game against St. John High School, coming up the side. Harrison Trimble chose to kick the ball into touch. On a penalty, they will receive the ball and able to put it back in through the line-in. There's a penalty advantage for St. John Ryan. Penalty for St. John High.
Go Hounds! Go
High! Number three off his feet. And St. John chooses to kick it, and it doesn't work. St. John elects to run the ball. The ball was knocked forward by St. John, which gives Harrison Trimble the ability to have a scrum down with their possession. There's an advantage. John Dean. Penalty for Harrison Trimble is number 24. St. John was playing the ball on the ground. You're not allowed to touch the ball once you are on the ground. Harrison Trimble chooses to kick the ball into touch, and they retain possession for a lineout. Did not enter the lineout straight, and therefore St. John has the option to choose if they want another lineout for their own possession or a scrum. They've chosen a lineout.
Alright. I'm gonna slip out there, boys. I'll be in and out. Hopefully it doesn't rain.
Yeah. Penalty advantage for St. John. They're able to play the advantage until they lose possession, or they break the play line. Great run by Keegan Hartley. The ball was knocked forward, unfortunately, during the tackle, so Harrison Trimble will gain the possession in a scrum.
Come on, Josh.
Josh the Bear, a monstrous run. It'll be a penalty for St. John against Harrison Trimble. St. John is in penalty advantage again. And they go back to the original penalty on a high tackle, with St. John having the penalty. And they choose to kick the ball into touch, and they retain it for a kick for a lineout. St. John attempted a short pass on that lineout, and the ball has to travel 5 yards for that to work, and unfortunately it didn't travel five. A penalty has been awarded, not a full penalty, to Harrison Trimble. Tristan DeRozier receives the ball.
Go to.
Carries it forward. Knock on advantage. Harrison Trimble trying to move the ball forward and retain the ball.
He's
the advantage has ended. As Harrison Trimble got to use the ball without repeating their play. When the ball goes into the in goal like this, it becomes a 22-meter drop. It was brought in by Harrison Trimble. So St. John is able to kick the ball from the 22-meter line. St. John looks for a hole in the... Harrison Trimble looks for a hole in the St. John defense.
Ooh.
There's now penalty advantage for Harrison Trimble. They'll go back to the mark of the penalty. And Trimble elects to kick the ball. The ball stayed inbounds for that kick. It went off of St. John High, and therefore it's a scrum down for Harrison Trimble. By the winger for St. John to keep the ball inbounds. Unfortunately, it bounced back into the in goal zone. Therefore, the ball gets turned back over to Harrison Trimble for the scrum. The referee deemed that the scrum was unsafe, and they're going to do it again with Harrison Trimble retaining the ball. Unfortunately, the St. John player went offside to pull the ball out of the scrum, and that's a penalty for Harrison Trimble. Now the kicker for Harrison Trimble will have a chance to convert for two more points. It's currently 5-0 for Harrison Trimble. And the try is successfully converted for Harrison Trimble. The score is now 7-0, Harrison Trimble.
No, I don't, so I want to keep track of this.
Let's go, let's go, let's go! Let's go, let's go! Let's go, let's go!
I'll probably just end up remembering it. It's a big deal. Ooh.
Jonathan, where you going, Jonathan?
I just don't want to forget one of this. So.
Yeah.
Scrum down to Harrison Trimble as the referee speaks to the players about some potential dangerous play.
Go home! Go, Jonathan!
The scrum, which is unsafe. Harrison Trimble elects to kick. And as the ball goes into touch, the assistant referee will mark where the line out will happen. It will be Harrison Trimble ball at the mark.
There's Katie Paul.
St. John is playing with a penalty advantage. We'll have the ball. Six White went off his feet at the breakdown. You can't leave your feet in rugby, or it's a penalty.
Let's go, Harris! Let's go, Harris! Let's go, Harris!
So John elects to kick, and the ball does not go into touch, so Harrison Trimble is able to return the ball.
Is that a high tackle?
That's a high tackle in that case. You have to keep your tackle below the neck, below the shoulders. So that was a high tackle, which returns the ball to Harrison Trimble. And Harrison Trimble kicks the ball into touch. Will retain possession at the mark of the assistant referee in the yellow, Damian Murphy. As we pass the 22-minute mark in the first half, the half will be 35 minutes long. So we're just over halfway in the first half, with Harrison Trimble leading 7-0. St. John's playing with a knock-on advantage. That's been replaced by a penalty for a high tackle. So again, a high tackle is anything above the shoulders. And St. John High elects to go for the line-out again. They've been successful with the line-out several times today, both their own and winning some from Harrison Trimble. The Harrison Trimble player went off his feet in the tackle, and therefore it's a penalty for St. John. St. John choosing again to keep their strong lineout game going. From the offside position, and that's what happened, unfortunately, for Harrison Trimble in that case, which gives the penalty to St. John. And there's 10 minutes left in this half. Marking the lineup, which the ref has changed to a penalty for. Penalty for throwing the ball away by St. John. So it's a penalty for Harrison Trimble. Which will return the line out
for Harrison Trimble.
Go, Greyhounds!
Play is inside the 22. If White receives the ball and decides to kick it again out, they'll retain possession.
So
they won't retain possession, they will move the ball down the field. As number one, Ben Campbell makes a big run. The referee is reminding the players in the scrum, in the number two position, the hooker, to watch not raising his foot early. Storming through the St. John team at center.
What a boy,
by Harrison Trimble, and the ball is returned to St. John for a scrum. Referee's just making sure the scrum is going to be safe. Covering some basics for safety in the scrum, and they're just going to reset. Still St. John ball. Jared Price decides to take a run with the ball for success.
What the heck?
Penalty advantage for St. John High.
Oh, John.
Players continuing to go off their feet at the break, and they have to keep their feet on the ground. St. John decides to kick in the touch and will retain possession for the lineup. Remaining in the half. Let's see how St. John does in another lineup. They've been strong all day. The ball went backwards, which is fine for Harrison Trimble in that case. So in that case, the Harrison Trimble players squeeze the ball back between their legs with their head down, and that's unsafe at the high school level. Creates a penalty for St. John, and they choose to kick the ball out.
Let's go, George!
The referee reminds them to keep the gap in the lineup. They have to guard the space in between the lineup. And this is forms into a mall. St. John brought the ball into a mall. Players have to join from the onside position. Ooh. It'll be a penalty against Harrison Trimble.
We go, let's go, guys!
warning for the Harrison Trimble team that you cannot collapse a ball once it has started. It is unsafe play, and I think if this continues in the second half, you'll see some cards being awarded. John Hedley. The ball went backwards off the pass, so that's fine. So John Hedley keep possession.
Let's go, T.
Number 15, Tristan DeRosier. This will be a final warning for Harrison Trimble. There's the yellow card award. The player has to leave the field. Harrison Trimble will be playing one man short for the next 10 minutes.
Let's go.
A nice switch play by St. John. Unfortunately knocked the ball forward after the pass. It's an advantage for Harrison Trimble in this case. It'll be a scrum down, Harrison Trimble ball.
What, about 2 minutes left?
Yeah. The referee is working to keep the scrum safe.
That's the last play. It'll go as long as until it goes out.
Come on, Ben.
Penalty against St. John, and we hear some trouble ball. Referee clarifies the penalty with St. John. This is the final play of the half. This will go until the ball goes out of bounds. Or there's a couple other scenarios that will stop this. But the game will play as long as the ball remains in play. Here's some trouble. That's to run the ball forward.
Oh.
nice hit.
We're reminding the players to stay behind the ball, stay behind the back foot of the tackle.
Yeah, come on, buddy.
The game cannot, the half cannot end on a penalty, so Harrison Trimble will retain possession.
What was the penalty?
They were offside. You gotta stay behind the back foot. You player? Or?
Yeah. I broke a collarbone.
Wow. That's terrible.
Yeah.
I broke my foot in high school and couldn't play in grade 12.
That's terrible. Yeah, I'm a little lucky. I'm only grade 11, so.
So with this penalty, Harrison Trimble is opted to kick for the posts, so they can kick for 3 points here instead of choosing to run the ball or kick the ball out of bounds. They're kicking for the post. The ball is live as it's kicked, but it is at the half. And with a successful kick, that's halftime. There will be a 10-minute halftime. Let's cheer on both teams. It's been a great game so far. 10-0 for Harrison Trimble over St. John High. Harrison Trimble starts off with a kick to St. John. St. John returning the ball strongly. Number 19, Sam Demuchel, scores for St. John. For St. John. It's currently 10-5. That's good.
That's him.
So you're showing the mission. Jason Dillon.
Kicker Jason Gillen will take an opportunity to convert an extra 2 points on this play. Harrison Trimble. We'll just remind the crowd that usually in rugby, when there's a kick, we don't make noise. It's just a protocol of rugby.
Ooh, atta boy. Keep the ball. Get over there.
Super heavy, but it's a little bit awkward.
Jason Demuchel continuing to bowl forward as the ball turns over to Harrison Trimble.
Get him out. I got it. Okay, just set it. Yeah, set it on the ground for now. That's good. Okay. And
penalty for Harrison Trimble. His number 7 on the St. John team was coming in through the side. to come in through the gate in rugby.
Okay, what I want you to do is...
Okay, Hal, get it back, boys, get it back!
Is there, right, you know where the mixer board is right here? Yeah. Is there power underneath it? Look underneath the bench. Like, look under, like...
Yeah, there's two.
Okay, is it open? Yeah, plug that in. And I'm gonna have you slide the mixer a little bit to the left. Yeah, and I'm gonna have you put that in the figure we just took down and put it horizontal.
St. John tries the short, or help, here's St. John tries the short line open. Yeah. The ball has to travel 5 yards for that to be legal. And unfortunately, it didn't travel 5 yards, so it's a penalty. Not a full penalty.
And then, open the window right away. Right out in the area. Now, I'm asking for him to pop the one with the red stripe.
Get to it.
Yeah, that's all the way down there, right? Yeah, that's all the way down there. Put the power on. Now, we gotta wait for him to talk.
All the players have to get onside after a
kick. Picture him the red dot up a bit. So you can hear him like next time he talks. Because then I'm going to bring this other one down. Because here's the grand frame. And it's kind of a pain to get these down. The only thing I'm worried about right now is feedback, right? So if that gets too loud, I'm worried about that screeching sound. Avoid that. We want that as loud as we can get it so everybody can hear it. There's a crowd here, eh?
Yeah.
Lots of people.
Is it a penalty advantage for St. John High?
Oh, you know what? Remember the cord? We're forgetting a cord.
Is Trimble still down there?
The one that dropped there? Make sure it's not tangled up. Yeah.
Yes.
Couple more minutes.
There you go. So turn the blind all the way down again, like that red one. Yeah. And plug it in the box.
9 minutes.
The one to the farthest left. Yeah. Just twist it until it fixes it.
Harrison Trumbull is playing with 14 players versus 15 because of the yellow card awarded in the first half. St. John puts together a strong ball, moves the ball forward.
Coming out of there.
They begin to move the ball through their backs. And unfortunately the ball is knocked forward.
My bad.
And it will be a scrum.
So you have that knob right now, put it at that's good. The bottom knob where the cord is plugged in. One down. Yeah, that has to go.
The yellow card player will return to the field from the sin bin after he's done his time for his penalty. He's received one yellow card. It will now be 15 players on 15 players again. There will be a sub as well for Harrison
Jumper. Hold here.
Strung down, there's a Trimble ball. Return by number 15, Tristan DeRosier.
Did you get it okay last time? Is it better to go this way?
I
can lay down here.
High tackle.
Can you sit that down anywhere now for now?
Go, Patty.
Oh, yeah, Patty.
Push that over.
Running and ball movement by St. John.
Over the line! Come on!
It's a penalty against Harrison Trimble or St. John. A yellow card for St. John, number 3. Liam Darling, you'll have to sit off for 10 minutes. Card awarded at 19 minutes and 28 seconds into the second half.
Releasing it back out. That's probably what he tried. He probably just didn't release.
Yeah, you gotta try to, if you leave your arms out and bring them back in, it shows everybody that you released.
I'm just surprised that he did it because he's really good at that.
Yeah, looks
like it.
St. John, as the ruck was formed. The player is not allowed to pick up the ball on the ground and play it when the ruck is formed, meaning there's tacklers and support over top of the tackle. And St. John opts to go for the lineout, which has been strong all day today.
Get
Push your fellas. There we go.
St. John has been successful with their lineouts today. One gets a bit away from them. Unfortunately, the ball went forward. It's going to be a knock-on advantage for Harrison Trimble. Score, which provided a penalty try for St. John. There won't be a yellow card because the exact person who made the high tackle wasn't able to be identified.
Is this 3 points, Gus?
It's five.
This is two.
No, sorry.
Two.
It's, so it's not a, you don't get it as a penalty.
No. They got five.
Yeah, no,
it's just a conversion.
It's just two, right?
Yeah.
Not the three.
Just a conversion.
I was kind of the penalty try it came with the 3 points.
That'd be nice.
And the kick is good for St. John. St. John takes the lead.
14-10.
The score is now 14 for St. John High School. 10, Harrison Trimble. Gone by, out of 35 minutes for this half, 14-10 for St. John High.
Bit high tap.
Hey boys, come on! Penalty advantage for St. John for on an offside call against Harrison Trimble. Let's see if St. John can't move the ball forward, it'll be brought back to center on this penalty advantage. And the ball is going to go back to center where the penalty occurred. Number one for Harrison Trimble was offside.
Do you happen to know how long is left on the sin bill?
what did we say it was 19?
I can't remember. Oh, 19 is when it ends?
Oh, maybe that's what he said. Yeah, I'm not sure. That would make sense. There's only a couple minutes left.
Yeah. I have 18, almost 19 minutes on this half, so.
Well, he stopped it down there during that, so.
Oh, yeah. What, Jason? Either way, probably pretty close.
You're saying 18 and a half, right? Yeah.
Yeah.
Harrison Trimble going, or rather, St. John High going for their strong lineup. Deciding to go with four people on the lineup. This is the option that St. John High has. The yellow card player returns to the field. Successful now for St. John High as they move the ball forward. Penalty advantage. There's a penalty advantage on that ball.
Again?
Players that are not in the lineup are not able to join the ball and join them all.
Oh, I didn't know.
In a lineout situation.
Good enough. Good job.
Yeah, so 18
minutes. Cool. Good
enough. It's so tempting, especially when it comes out close to you. You have to keep backing up.
Yeah. I'm surprised Harris and Trimble hasn't just backed off it yet, because they don't have to oppose. Oh, good catch, buddy. Yes. No, don't throw it away, T.
St. John continuing to press the on field against Harris and Trimble. Score as the ball was knocked forward. There'll be a scrum down on the 5-yard line as the ball is knocked on. The score remains 14-10 for St. John High. The ball was knocked forward.
Good game.
That mauling is really taking you guys far.
Yeah.
Your coach is Jeff Ward.
Yeah.
I know his brother Jamie.
Yeah.
Played together and saw him the other day.
Yeah, no, like I'm saying, since they're getting destroyed by that mom, I don't know why they're opposing it, because we can't keep going if they don't oppose.
Some trouble kicking out. The ball goes backwards. It's fine. Continue to play on. There's an offside call. So where the player was in front of the ball, he was unfortunately offside. And the ball goes back to Harrison Trimble. On a penalty.
That's a weird move. Oh, jeez.
And Harrison Trimble uses the opportunity to kick the ball out and get a lineup.
Let's go, Ralph! Let's go, Ralph! Do you mind announcing the 50-50?
Sure.
Let's go, Ralph! Let's go, Ralph! Right here!
12 minutes remaining in the half.
Steal the lineup, boys!
Nice catch.
Knock-on advantage for Harrison Trimble. They're retaining the ball. They weren't able to use the advantage, so it'll be a strung down. Harrison Trimble ball. It was knocked on by Gray during the tackle. And it was strung down.
Fans are excited. Nice tackle.
The referee's letting them know the tackle is made, so they have to watch and stay on side. Strung forward or brace forward. Strung down for St. John I. The Trojan fans start to come alive. Cheer on their team. 14-10. Collapsed, which is unsafe play, and it's going to be a penalty for
what a boy.
St. John High. It looks like they're going to opt to go for their line out again, which has been strong all game. Position is marked again by the assistant referee. St. John High goes, attempts the maul.
Come on,
the ball comes free. Out to the backs.
Let's go, Patty. Keep that, Patty. That was good.
There was no luck for him, so the player was able to get back up and run. And number 19, Sam Michelle, runs out of bounds. A great run. And it'll be a Harrison Trimble lineup. And St. John has the opportunity to match numbers in the lineup. And a well executed lineup by Harrison Trimble. And jumper number 6, Marky Mom. Big roll ahead by number 8, Brody Fall.
That guy is huge. Yes!
Seven, Matt Oxner, pulls through. And we have penalty for offside against Harrison Trimble. Let's see what St. John I will choose to do here. Players cannot jump in the air at contact in rugby. They can't leave their feet. It's unsafe play, and that's why we had the penalty.
Let's go.
on high as Harrison Trimble boosted their player early. We're going to come back to the penalty for boosting early. St. John High wasn't able to capitalize on their penalty. Get your 50-50 tickets out. I have the winning ticket here in my hand. Get your 50-50 tickets out. The winner is 197-997. 197-997. Right in front of the booth here. Young lady with the bucket will be happy to pay the winner. 197-997. The winning 50-50 number was 197-997. It's an advantage for...
Let's go!
Advantage for Harrison Trimble. It's the same penalty we saw a couple of minutes ago against Harrison Trimble. St. John High boosted their player too early in the lineup. So this is going to be a full penalty as opposed to a half penalty. So both teams are going to want to watch in the lineup. Watch their lineouts that they're not boosting their player early. If they do, they need to return the player to the ground immediately.
Get that ball into your back! Let's go! Come on, help! Let's get at it!
Back up.
Very nicely executed by Harrison Trimble. Number 6, Mark Dimon with the lift it into the air. Big run for Harrison Trimble.
He did not release that. At all.
Penalty advantage for Harrison Trimble.
Yes.
We're going to go back to the penalty for the player not attempting to wrap in a tackle. In rugby, you need to wrap the player in a tackle. The referee goes back to the penalty mark. Harrison Trimble chooses to run the ball.
Oh.
It'll be another penalty. Because the players were back 10, caused the second penalty. That might have been a high tackle.
Let's go, Hounds. Come on.
There's an offside call against St. John. Harrison Trimble will receive the ball for their penalty. So go back to the ring number 8. The referee reminds the players to stay onside. Strong defense here from St. John.
Yes, get that. Offside. Yes.
It's a penalty against Harrison Trimble. Unlucky position to get a penalty in their own end.
That's a...
St. John end, we got St. John with the penalty advantage. They'll choose to kick. Oh, penalty was on number three for Harrison Trimble. He was came into the ruck into the side and then played the ball with his hands. St. John Edwards lineout, which is stolen by Harrison Trimble. Ball bounces around. We got a knock-on advantage for Harrison Trimble. They're not able to use the advantage, so it'll be a scrum down for Harrison Trimble.
Oh no.
During the scrum, the player on the St. John team raised his foot early, and that's a partial penalty to the advantage of Harrison Trimble.
Let's go, Jason. Get that out, get that out, get that out. What? He has his... Oh.
And that's the end of the game. That was 14-10 for St. John High School. Congratulations, St. John High School, on becoming